हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ अमृता श्रीवास्तव एंड आई एम फैकल्टी ऑफ US Academy Institute गोरखपुर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्लास 8 मॉरल साइंस. दिस इज़ योर 6th चैप्टर एंड द टाइटल इज डू गुड डू गुड. दैट मीन्स डूइंग गुड फील्स गुड. दिस चैप्टर इज अबाउट कंपैशन, एंड्योरेंस एंड गुडनेस. दैट मीन्स पिटी, पेशेंस एंड योर goodness. There might be many people remembered by you because of their goodness. So students, in your life there would be many people that you remember them just because of their goodness. So when did you do something good for somebody? You have to remember it. So this is a story of a poor girl. Let's read the story and understand what is going on in this story. There was a little girl who was very poor. Her parents had died long ago. She had no place to live in and no bed to sleep in and nothing to eat except one piece of bread. So this is story of a little girl. She was very poor and her parents had died very long before. And the girl was having no place to live and to no bed to sleep, and only she was having one piece of bread for eating. One day after saying her prayer, she put on her jacket and cap, took her piece of bread and went out. So it is a story of one day when she decided to go for a walk. And she was having a jacket, a cap, and she just took her piece of bread and went out of her place. When she had walked a little way, there was an old man sitting who had nothing to eat. He looked at the piece of bread and said, "Will you give me your bread, little girl?" So, what happened next? When she walked little, there was a old man who was sitting under a tree. And he just looked the piece of bread in the hand of the little girl and asked if she will give him her piece of bread just because the man was already very hungry. So after hearing this, the little girl thought for some time and she was ready to give her piece of bread to the old man. The girl was hungry herself, but she endured the pangs of hunger and walked along. As she had walked a little further, she came across a child sitting by the path. Crying, "I am so cold," murmured the child, "won't you give me your little cap to keep my head warm?" The little girl thought a little and took off her cap and put it on the child's head. She was hungry and cold, but she did not complain and walked on. After an hour, she met another child. This one, shivering in the cold, said to her, "Won't you give me your jacket, little girl?" And as is usual, she thought a little and gave away her jacket. She moved on, now shivering and starving. Further on, she saw another child crouching by the wayside. "Oh, little girl," screamed out the child, "won't you give me your dress? I have nothing to keep myself warm." God knows, this time without a grumble, she took off her dress and gave it to that child. What happened next? When the girl kept walking, he just not complaining about the pain of her hunger and just keep walking. Suddenly, she saw a little child was crying and he said, "Please give me your cap to keep my head warm." The little girl thought a little and just took off her cap and put it on the head of the child. She was hungry also and she was feeling cold, but she did not complain. After 1 hour, she met another child. And that child was also shivering from the cold and said, "Please give me your jacket, little girl." and little girl without any complaining just gave her jacket to that little child. And after some time she saw another child was shivering from the cold and he was not having any kind of cloth. So he asked that, please give me your dress to keep myself warm. And this time also, without any complaint, without any murmur, she just took off her dress and gave it to that little child. She had nothing left but her little shirt. It grew dark and the wind was cold. Thus she crept into the buses to sleep for night. In the buses, a child was lying weeping. I am chilled to be born, to the bone, she sobbed, give me your little shirt. The little girl thought, it is dark and the buses will shelter me, so I should give her my little shirt. She gave it, now she had nothing left. After some time, the girl was in the buses to keep herself warm, and as we know, she was not having any place for sleeping. So just for sleep and keep herself warm, she took shelter in the bushes. And there one another girl child was weeping there, and she said, please give me your little shirt to keep myself warm. It's very cold and my bones are freezing. So that time little girl thought, just because she was having only that little shirt on her body, but she gave it to the girl child, and she just thought that in the buses no one was there to see her, and so she gave her shirt to that little child. And in the night she sat looking up at the sky to say her night prayer. As she looked up, the whole sky full of stars fell in a shower around her feet. It was her habit to offer prayer to the God at the morning and the night also. So in the night she started her prayer, and suddenly she looked that the whole sky was full of stars and it was falling down in a form of shower around her feet. There they were on the ground, shining bright and twinkling. The stars were on the ground that time and they were shining and twinkling. The little girl saw them turning into food, clothes and gold coins. It was very surprising for her that when she saw that the stars were turning into warm clothes and gold coins, and they were converted into foods. And in the middle of the them was the finest little dress woven out of warm wool. And between the middle of all these things, gold coins, clothes and food, there was a pretty warm little dress. So the little girl put on the little dress and had her meal heartily, and then she gathered the gold coin just because her endurance and pretty nature. The girl got all these things, the little dress, and she just took her meal and she collected the gold coins. Her endurance to bear pain and hunger for the sake of others had been rewarded by God. All the things she got just because of her endurance to tolerate the pain, her pain and hunger for the sake of others. The girl was too hungry and she was suffering from the cold also, but she gave all these things to the other childs and the old people, and this was the reward given by the God to her, that at the last she just got gold coins, food and pretty dresses for her. So students, that was all about your story. Do good, too good, that means if you will do good to others, it will be too good for you also. Let's discuss the questions of this chapter. These questions orally. First question is saying, what kind of person was the little girl? The little girl was poor but very endurance, full of endurance and kind-hearted girl. What was she carrying when she left? She was carrying a jacket, a cap and a piece of bread. How many needy people met the little girl? 4 needy people met the little girl. What did she offer them respectively? First of all, she offered a piece of bread to the man. And after that, she offered her cap to one child. She offered her jacket to second child. Then she offered her clothes to the third child. And at the last, she took off her little shirt for the fourth child. What did the God offer him in the end? God offered her in the end gold coins, a pretty little woolen dress and foods. Everybody knows that Mother Teresa was known for her kindness. Take the right options to pay your homage to her. What nationality was Mother Teresa born into? First question is saying, what nationality was Mother Teresa born into? Answer is Indian. What name was given to Mother Teresa at baptism? Answer is D. Agnes. Third question is saying, Mother Teresa was born on August 26, 1910, but when did she die? So the correct answer is September 5, 1997. It is given 1197, but correct answer is 1997. Please do correction here. What type of family was Mother Teresa born into? Answer is Catholic. And last is, it is true to say Mother Teresa became a nun with the missionary Loreto Sisters of Ireland? Answer is true. Write T for true and F for false. The little girl was very rich. False. Old man was very hungry. True. The girl was hungry herself, but she endured the pangs of hunger and walked alone. True. In the night, the little girl sat looking up at the sky to say her night prayer. That is also true. So students, what is the moral of this chapter? Kindness is the first and foremost gift by all sorts of almighties like sun, earth, moon and etc. Gain of the day, a feel of compassion increases the strength of endurance. So students, that was all about your 6th chapter, Do Good, Do Good. We will discuss our next chapter in our next video. Till then, take care.